Okay, so let's start with the 84th example. An aircraft loops the loop of radius 500 meter with a constant velocity of 360 km per hour. So radius is 500 meter. The velocity is 360 km per hour. So we should convert this into meter per second by multiplying with by 5 by 18. 18 ones are 18, 2s are 36. So velocity comes out to be 100 meter per second. We need to find the weight of the flyer whose mass is 70 kg in the lower, upper and middle points of the loop. Okay, so here in this case, first of all, we should know very basic information about weight. Weight is nothing but the normal reaction from surface, or in this case from the seat. From the seat, whatever the normal reaction is felt by the flyer, that will be the weight experienced by that flyer. Okay, so while looping the loop, when the flyer is in the lower point, okay, so when the flyer is passing through the lowest point of the circle, its weight will be acting in the downward direction and reaction will be in upward direction. Here, in order to complete the loop, in order to go in the curved path, to get the necessary centripetal force, N must be greater than mg, and the difference between N and mg must provide the necessary centripetal force. So therefore, the weight felt will be equal to mv square upon r plus mg, where mv square upon r, so m is 70 kg, the v is 100 square upon 500 meter plus 70 into, for easy calculation I am taking g as 10, for accurate you can also take 9.8 to get the accurate result. So 10 into, this will be 4 zeros divided by 500, 700. These two zeros will get cancelled out. 7 ones are 7, 2s are 10, 5 2s are 10 and 0. So 7 2s are 14, so it will be 1400 plus 700. So the normal reaction will be 2100 Newton. So that would be 2.1 kilonewton. So that is the weight felt when the flyer is passing through the lower point. Okay, now in the second part, upper position. So when the flyer is passing through the upper position of the loop, so in that case the weight is acting in the downward direction, the reaction from the seat is also acting in the downward direction. So both together both of them will provide necessary centripetal force. So N plus mg will provide mv square upon r. So N will be equal to mv square upon r plus mg. Already we have calculated, so N will be, this will be minus, na? When this mg will go there, it becomes minus. So this must be minus. Now mv square upon r, that we have already calculated here, mv square upon r is already known to us, which is 1400. So we don't have to solve again and again. So it will be 1400 minus 700. So if we subtract from this, so 1400 minus 700 will be, comes out to be, so again it comes out to be 700 Newton. So the weight felt will be 700 Newton or 0.7 kilonewton as there in the answers section. Third, in the middle point, when the flyer is looping the loop through the middle point along the curve path, then in that case the weight is acting in the downward direction and the reaction is here. So whatever the reaction we are getting, that is nothing but the weight felt by N. So N will be alone provide necessary centripetal force, which is mv square upon r, and which is nothing but 1400. So that would be 1.4 kilonewton. Already we have calculated mv square upon r, that's why I am not solving it again and again. So this is the answer. These are the answers to this question. Thank you.